Hello everybody and welcome back to Banjo-Kazooie. Today is the finale, but don't worry, there is going to be a bonus video, so stick around for that. Of course, make sure you're subscribed, like this video, leave a comment down below and let me know what you think of this video once you've watched it. Before we get started, I have a couple things I want to share with you. First and foremost, I uploaded a timed exclusive video over on Patreon of a Banjo-Kazooie mod. It's an hour-long video of me playing the entirety of a Banjo-Kazooie mod called The Bear Waker, which takes Outset Island from The Wind Waker and turns it into a Banjo-Kazooie world with like 10 jiggies. It actually has 200 notes instead of 100. So there's lots to collect. There's a bunch of puzzles, very Zelda-esque, but also very Banjo-esque. Excuse me, Mr. King of Red Lions, can I ride in you? Can I sit inside of you? Hell yeah. The Bear Waker. It's super cool, and I had a ton of fun doing it. That video will actually be out publicly next month, but if you want to watch it now, become a patron, a patron at the link in the description. And by the way, if we hit 50 total patrons over on that channel, I'm going to be playing another Banjo-Kazooie mod publicly on this channel called Jiggies of Time, which is Ocarina of Time themed worlds in Banjo-Kazooie. So it's so cool, and you guys absolutely should go and check that out if you've got a couple bucks to throw at me. Thank you so much for all of your support. And without further ado, let's jump into Banjo-Kazooie yet again. Let's take a look at the file select here. Seven hours and 43 minutes. I'm sure there's lots of times that I was sitting here just like with the game on after I recorded or whatever. That's a long time. Normally, I beat this game in like 4 hours casually, normally. 100 jiggies, 900 notes, that's everything, man. Let's jump into it. Before we go on to the final fight against our girl Gruntilda here, there is a game over cutscene that we have not seen. It is, let's see. If you save and quit, you get the game over cutscene. So let's take a look for anybody who has not seen this before. If you're new to the Banjo series, here we go.
Banjo's game ends in my tower. Turn it up, I need full power.
Come on, Kalungo.
Yes, your Grunty ship. Transformation soon be complete.
Help me, Banjo! I feel all funny!
Bear and bird finished. Grunty wins.
Oh no, she's hot!
Look at Grunty's beauty. I'm much prettier than Tootie.
Oh, you are, mistress.
Mumbo, what are you doing here?
Grunty, nice. Come back to Mumbo's skull, yes?
Oh. Tootie!
Banjo, your sister wants a word with you now.
We don't talk about Tootie. No, no. Well, anyway, that's the bad ending. If you die or quit the game, you get the bad ending. Y'all, you have no idea. I'm so excited for this next part. The final fight with Grunty is fantastic, but the part before it, you'll see. You'll see. You know what I'm talking about. I'm excited. I thought I would start at the beginning of Grunty's lair and just sort of have like a little nostalgia moment about this series, because this is a very important series to me. I've talked about it throughout, and those of you who have been watching along for the whole series, thank you so much. This is a very important series for me. It really is. And there's a lot of emotions today. I'm feeling very, I don't know, it feels very heavy that we're finishing this up already. You know, it's not a terribly long game, and there's plenty more Banjo stuff to come now that I'm, you know, finishing this up. But I don't know, it just feels very bittersweet, you know? Today I'm wearing my Jiggy hat. This is a custom Jiggy hat that my dad gave me. My dad, of course, was the one who played Banjo-Kazooie with me when I was a kid. Before I could barely read when this game first came out. And so, of course, there's lots of dialogue in this game, and, my dad had to help me, like, learn how to read everything. Get away from me, big butt. So, you know, this is a very nostalgic game for that reason. And so he sent me this custom Jiggy hat. This is a patch that he got off of Etsy. So you can probably search it on Etsy if you want to do something similar. And then he had his friend sew this on for me, and then he sent it to me. And I'm just like, I'm just so grateful, you know, that my dad is like a creative, like, honestly, he's one of my biggest inspirations in my life for being a creative person. He does a lot of stuff. He built a puppet for me. He made a puppet of myself for me, which is so cool. I've shown it off on stream before. And he made this hat and a few other things. And, you know, he used to build guitars and stuff like that. I am, you know, I love my dad. My mom is the same way. My mom is very creative. So I get it from them, you know, and I owe them a lot, and Banjo-Kazooie makes me think of them every time, so. Alright, here we go. Through the 765 note door with my 900 notes! I'm very excited. Can you tell? I'm all hyped up today, baby! I'm all hyped up! One more thing that I want to do before we actually- oh, sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off there, Grunty. Why am I apologizing to Grunty? Like, one more thing I want to show off before we go into the finale here is my totals. I want to look at all the totals from all of the worlds in this. So if we go back to game totals, of course, this is everything. Spyro Mountain, of course. Grunty's Lair. Mumbo's Mountain. Treasure Trove Cove. Clanker's Cavern. Bubba Gloop Swamp. Freeze Easy Peak. Gobi's Valley, Mad Monster Mansion, Rusty Bucket Bay, Click Clock Wood, and then, of course, the entire stop and swap screen, which looks awesome when you've completed it, right? That's so cool. I love seeing it completed. Of course, it's useless in this version of the game. It's totally, completely useless, but it's there. It's done. Alrighty. Oh! Oh, she's still talking.
If you think I'm rather soft, I'll be waiting in the loft.
That's not, that was a very unthreatening thing to say. There's Tootie. All right, here you go. Welcome to Grunty's Furnace of Fun. Come on down. The first contestant on Grunty's Furnace Fun.
Welcome all, Grunty's the name. Banjo's here to play my game. My lair is done and here he stands through all my tricks and traps and lands. This final test will see me win. When Banjo fails, then I'll be thin. The prizes on this stand bring joy from Tootie down to cuddly toy.
I have that toy, by the way. Fangamer has that now, I've got it.
And Tootie, you shall never get, cause somewhere soon along the way, your lack of skill will make my day. Cause in the fiery pit you'll go, and I will win the prize on show. So step on over to the square, press A to try if you dare.
Okay. And there's one final warp pot. This is one that we actually haven't found the companion to yet. Let's go.
A little answer's all I'll seek. About this game. You furry geek.
Wow, you're a geek. So yeah, we have to answer her questions. There's a bunch of different kinds of questions. There's Banjo-Kazooie questions. There are questions about the game that you just played. There's picture questions. They'll show you a picture and then you have to answer with like what's in that picture. Like it'll be like a close-up picture and kind of like hard to tell what it is. There's Grunty questions, which are all of the answers that you get from Bruntilda throughout the game. So you have to kind of remember which ones she mentioned. There are musical questions where they'll play a song or a sound effect and you have to answer what that thing is. There are timed challenges, so they'll time you for certain challenges that you've already completed throughout the game. So like things like the matching game in Gobi's Valley, like all of the other little mini games that you've done before. There's a lot of them too, like Mr. Vile is in there. The Flibbits, I think, are in there. Are the Flibbits in there? No, the Zubbas are, though. The bees from ClickClock Wood. So there's a lot of things like that. There's also a bonus square for getting skips. So you can get two cards. If you answer a random question correctly, you can get two cards, and they will allow you to skip certain squares. And then, of course, there's one final square, which is the Skull Square, which if you get the answer wrong, it's a random question, could be a Grunty question, very dangerous. If you get it wrong, you die instantaneously. So here we go. First question.
On Mumbo's Mountain, surrounded by sea, there's a Jinjo. What color is he?
Surrounded by sea, blue. Because he's surrounded by sea. They usually, a lot of the Jinjos are color-coded to where they're at. Some of them are.
A lucky guess you got it right. The next square's yours without a fight.
I can only imagine Grunty's Furnace Fun being very difficult for people who are very new to this game.
Tell me who it is, or...
Oh, I skipped it by accident. Here's a character from the game. Do you know the dumb thing's name? Poor Gobi! Everybody's against Gobi. Poor guy. Dimbo and Gumby. Gumby, who remembers Gumby? All right, Gobi. God, I remember Gumby. Okay, I'm gonna, oh, I was gonna save that life, but I accidentally touched it.
Mad Monster Mansion's graveyard pots. What appeared from them?
There were lots. What appeared from them? Well, they all said fuck you, so. A bunch of bananas. It was a bunch of flowers. Boo. I love how you get the answers right and they boo at you.
Listen carefully to this tune. Which world's it from, you furry goon?
Clankers Cavern, Clankers Cavern, Clankers, Clankers Cavern. That is Click Clock Click Clock Cavern. Clankers Clock. They try to throw you off with these bullshit answers sometimes. All right, so this is the Joker Square. You can get skips by doing it, but I'm afraid because sometimes you can get like grunty questions in these ones, and the grunty questions are very difficult because the answers change every time you start a new file. So you always have to go to Bryntilda and find out what the answers are, or if you skip Bryntilda throughout the game, you just kind of have to guess or remember, which, you know, I'm not that great at remembering stuff in the first place, so.
Bubble Gloop's turtle opens wide. What did you hit to get inside? His feet! His butt.
Smack his ass. I clapped those cheeks and he let me in. Whoa. I don't know about all that.
Here's a character from the game. Do you know the dumb thing's name?
Wow. That's like the easiest question I've ever received in this whole video game.
It's a Banjo, of course.
A Banjo.
Rusty Bay's crane hangs over the side. It holds a box, but what's inside?
Now there's a crate and then there's a box though. Grunty's expensive new hi-fi. Yeah, it's a TNT. That's obvious. All right, here's the first time challenge.
Prepare yourself to take a whack. Pick this test, you won't come back.
All right. Oh, this is like the easiest one too. Hell yeah.
But tiles are way for you to match. Time is tight, but that's the catch.
Oh, I should have filled up on gold feathers before I did started this, but yeah, so normally this is not timed, but today it is timed. And it's actually a pretty tight timer, all things considered. So, wish me luck. I'm gonna try to remember things. We all know that I don't remember the order of this at all, and I told you. Told you. Oh, shoot. This is the feather, right? Nope. Oh, no. I'm gonna screw this up, aren't I? Okay, thank God. Okay, Kazooie's there. I think this is the other Kazooie. This is what? Banjo. Banjo was down here, right? Yep. This is feather. So is this. This is the honeycomb, and so is this. And this is, of course, the blue egg. I screwed it up a little bit, but that's okay. Still pretty fast. So long as you're pretty quick with your movement between hitting the things, you have a lot of chances, so. All right, guys, first grunty question. I could skip it, but I'm gonna save it, I think, for a death square. See how much you know of little old me. Here we go.
A lovely specimen in its pot. It's by my bed. What have I got? Ooh, I know this one.
I'm so glad I talked to Bryntilda. It was an eyeball flower.
Yeah. Oh, God. I'm so glad I talked to Bryntilda.
I'm going to see if I can get through this without losing any health. That would be nice. Of course, saying that now, I've just kind of screwed myself. You know what? We'll do the first death square. We're gonna hit like a couple more death squares that I kind of want to like use the skips on later ones, maybe? Let's see, how many death squares? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 5 between here and the end on the pathway that I'm taking anyway. Maybe 6. Actually, technically there's 4 if I don't go for the second like skip cards, but here, let's just do this and see what happens. The galley fridge in Rusty Bay. Tell me what on the shelves lay. It was eggs, right? Grunty's high fat spread. Okay, it was eggs.
You want to hear us? I can tell. In which band do I sing so well?
Oh my god. The Cauldron Crew, the Broomstick Boys, the Monster Mob. Oh my god, I don't remember this one. Did I miss a Gruntilda? Cauldron Crew. Oh my god. That was kind of a lucky guess, because I didn't remember that one, to be honest with you.
See the picture on my screen? Do you know where I have been?
Where you have been? Oh my god, that could be any place with a fire pit. But I think it's Naughty's house in ClickClock Wood. There's a good few fireplaces in this game, so. All right, I'm gonna skip this one.
Your Joker misses out a square, except the test you did not dare.
Yeah, that's just straight facts, dude.
Listen up now, then make your choice. Which character has this dumb voice?
Is that Gruntilda? Did she just call her sister dumb? That's really funny, actually. It's either Gruntilda or Tootie, isn't it? Tootie the nasty bear, but I think it's Gruntilda. Tootie and Gruntilda have very similar voices, I think. All right, here's another time challenge. These aren't too bad unless they're Mr. Vile.
Mighty big box, you must now fight, but be quick as time is tight.
I'm just gonna gold feather him. Can we do that? I'm just gonna gold feather him. Is that cool? Is that cool with everybody? Is that cheating? Am I cheating right now? I feel like I'm cheating. I feel like this shouldn't be as easy as it is, but here we are. I did waste all my gold feathers though doing it. So if I do get another challenge that I need gold feathers in, like the Zubbas or something. Zubbas are easy though. The boombox is harder. What wakes the ghost from his sleep? Banjo sets off his alarm clock. Banjo treads on the creaky floorboards. That's the right answer. Banjo hits him with a plank of wood. I wish. We never did test that, though. I was too good. See the picture on my screen. Do you know where you have been? No. I don't know. Treasure trove? It is treasure trove. That's easy. That's a very, like, iconic stack of boxes to me. Hells yeah, dude. All right, another Grunty question. Let's go.
Grunty's cute. She's quite a dame. What was my first boyfriend's name?
Oh, I remember this. It was Dirty Birdie.
Dirty Birdie.
It's a good thing that these answers are so funny. They make them more memorable. How many jigsaws does he have? Wait, what? Who? Something clot? I didn't see what the question was. I missed the first part of the question because I wasn't paying attention. I was too busy talking. That's fine. One life hit. Freezeezy Snowman has a giant scarf. What are its colors that make me barf? Yellow and red. All right, that's fine. I just got an extra life anyway, and I'm going to skip that one. And then we'll get another set of two for the other death squares. The fewer death squares I could do, the better. That is the well from Mumbo's Mansion. Mumbo's Mansion? Mumbo got real rich. Alrighty, let's see what this is. Clanker's cavern, whale needed air. What did you swim through way down there? It was a giant key. The sound barrier! You swam through the sound barrier! Imagine Banjo and Kazooie swimming at the speed of sound, past the speed of sound even.
Remember now before you lose, what type of toothpaste do I use?
Oh god, what was it? Was it tuna ice cream or was it salted slug? I think it was tuna ice cream. Brick, it was salted slug, wasn't it? Salted slut.
Look at my hair, see it flow. What is it washed with, do you know?
Oh God, it was engine oil. It was engine oil. Yeah. Good, I remember things.
You pick up items on the ground, which one makes this silly sound?
Gold feather? Gold necklace. I actually need some gold feathers pretty soon here, but that's okay. By the way, if you get enough notes throughout the game, there are refills before the boss. So we'll get to that. So we won't have to like go back and grind for anything. Oh my God, I was saying I needed gold feathers right now.
Little stings that make a bear shout. Whack them all before time's out.
This is the game's getting revenge on me for cheating earlier in the game when I had to use the gold feathers to beat this. So now I have to use my rat-a-tat-tap, and I'm not doing too hot at the moment. Oh, there's only one left now anyway, I think. Cool. Yeah, I took way too many damages there. Way too much damage, but that's okay. We've only got technically two more squares left, so we should be okay.
On Mumbo's mountain, it's not dull. What's in the eye of Mumbo's skull? It's a jiggy.
Wait. Music notes, Mumbo token, something else. Wow, they're trying to throw me off, huh? They're trying to throw me off. You think I don't know Mumbo's freaking mountain?
Guess this right or you may lose. What's the only color I'd choose?
Oh, it was dung brown, wasn't it? Oh, it was gruesome green then. Dang. Let's see if you remember he's foggy. It is. What's the name of my pet doggy? Oh no. Was it Ripper? I don't remember this one either. Okay. That was a guess, to be honest with you. But anyway, here's the last one, and I don't even have to answer it. Should I do it? Should I do it anyway? No, we've come this far. I don't want to screw myself. That would be bad.
No one can win, I was assured by the makers of this board. It's not fair, I want to win. How I'd long to be real thin. Now you can take the prize on show. Well, up the winding stairs I go. You won't catch me, I've made sure. All the credits you'll now endure.
Woo! Judy! What's up?
Well, which prize shall we take, Kazooie?
Me, 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 me.
How about that grotty ugly thing?
I think we should take Tootie.
That's what I meant! Kazooie!
Please, can I go home now, Banjo? I've had enough adventuring for one day.
Sure, let's get... wait, has it only been one day? This whole adventure took a day? Jesus. Alrighty, and that's it. That's the whole game. That was the final boss. Just kidding, there's more. Don't worry. But we gotta watch the credits first. So during the credits, I wanted to just give a couple of general, like, I just wanted to throw a few things out there. You guys are freaking amazing. Like, the amount of comments and interaction that this series has gotten is something I haven't seen on my channel in years. It's something I mentioned this, I think, earlier in the series, but I wanted to talk about it again. I've been losing subscribers on YouTube for the last couple of years, and I've been very inconsistent and mostly focusing on the Twitch channel for a while. So pretty much since 2015, 2016, I've been focusing on the Twitch channel. And in the last 6 months or so, I've really ramped up my efforts here on YouTube, and it's shown. And I cannot do it without you guys. So thank you so much for being a part of this series and being here with me to watch me play my favorite game of all time and hype up my favorite game of all time and hopefully introduce new people to it, especially now that it's on the Switch. That's the most exciting thing that's happened this in the last freaking for a long time, last 5 years of my life. the entire time that the Switch has been out, it's been now almost 5 years. The Switch is 5 years old now. Isn't that crazy? And the fact that Banjo-Kazooie is now available on a home Nintendo console for the first time since 2000, because, you know, Banjo-Tooie, but, yeah, and the first time since 2001, really, that Banjo has been on a Nintendo console, or 2003, I guess, if you count Banjo Pilot, but, man, I just love this series to death, man. I love it to death. I love the character parade at the end here. This is so cool. You get to, like, know the names of all the characters that you, like, you missed out on. There's a second character parade, actually, too, at the end of the game. And, yeah, you guys are just freaking incredible. And I couldn't continue to do this channel without you on my side, without you guys down in the comments section leaving comments. I've been reading them every day. It's gotten to a point where it's, like, it's kind of, like, my morning ritual to go and log into my YouTube Studio app and just, like, scroll through the comments and like things and look at things and respond to things. And so I'm down there all the time. So thank you so much for leaving those wonderful, wonderful comments. I'm excited to play more. We've got a lot more Banjo content on the horizon. Like I mentioned at the very start of this video, I did a mod of Banjo-Kazooie The Bear Waker by Kirko Mods. And I uploaded that for Patreon. It's an hour-long video of me playing the entirety of that mod, and it's incredible. You guys should check it out. I would absolutely love your support. If we get 50 total patrons over on Patreon at any tier, you don't even have to subscribe to a specific tier. You'll get all of the videos no matter what amount you give to Patreon. So if you want to throw $2 at Patreon, do it. But if you want to support at a higher tier or whatever, you get a few extra things. And if we hit 50 total patrons, I'm going to be visiting Banjo Mods again with Jiggies of Time, which is probably the biggest, most complete Banjo-Kazooie mod out there. It's an entire full game that takes place in Ocarina of Time-themed Banjo worlds. So, like, Kakariko Village and, like, Castletown and stuff like that. I actually don't know what's in it. The only thing I've seen from it is, like, a little tiny bit of Kakariko Village, and it looks amazing. So you do not want to miss out on that. Become a patron, get those videos way earlier than everybody else. And come support the channel in a big way. You guys are absolutely incredible. I could not do this without your support. So consider helping out if you can. And I mean, that's all I gotta say, man. I'm just excited for the final fight coming up here in a second. So stick around after the credits because we've got so much more to come. Oh, there's Naughty! He's so naughty. I think my favorite experience was ClickClock Wood, honestly. It was my least favorite experience during the moment, but everything that conspired in the ClickClock Wood episodes, like, it changed my entire thing because I was originally gonna do only, I was only gonna do one level per video, and then ClickClock Wood happened. It came out to be like an hour and 20 minutes. Hey, it's Banjo and Kazooie! Hurry up and get us home, Banjo!
I'm going as fast as I can.
Hey, look over there! We missed a carrot!
Got him. Are you happy now?
Come on! Oh, come on, you two! Huh? It's ready to party!
Great, I could do with a drink.
Banjo drinks confirmed. Banjo, I thought you were sober now. Mumbo cooking the goldfish. Oh no, Mumbo's cooking Banjo's goldfish. The goldfish, by the way, has a name. His name is Royston.
Very good. Help Mumbo.
What? Help Mumbo what? I missed that.
Corn! Huh? Yeah, but they needed my amazing moves to do it, huh?
No way. Me and Banjo were the stars of this game.
Always breaking the fourth wall. Love your shades.
Huh? What's the party for? Grunty got away, so get back up there and finish the job!
I'm not going.
No, yes you are. Let's go.
And right back into it. All right, guys. The next phase begins. Are you ready to rumble? To rumble in the bumble? Because I am. Up the winding stairs we go. Oh, I'm scared now. This is terrifying. This is the room from the beginning cutscene where Dingpot was and Grunty was like, Dingpot, by the bench, who's the nicest looking wench? And Dingpot was let it slip that Tootie existed. Poor Ding, like, freaking Dingpot ruined the whole thing. Dingpot is the whole reason we're on this adventure at this point now. So there's that other pod that goes back to the beginning of Furnace Fun there. But I love how there's more note doors after that. So you need so much. There is a lot of collectibles to get in this game, and you need so much of it to complete it. That's one of the things I personally really love about this game. Something like Mario Sunshine is a great example. You need so few of the things to complete that game that everything you collect post-game basically doesn't matter at all, and there's not that much in the way of completion bonuses or anything. Whereas Banjo gives you so much, and you really only need to, like, get... You don't even need to get 100%, but you need to get all, like... to like 98% of everything in the game in order to unlock all of the doors and, you know, so. I like that. It makes the game way more challenging. All right. Oh, and there's another puzzle, and this one's totally empty.
It's not over, stupid bear. See my picture over there? To fill it up is no mean feat. Lots of jiggies make it complete.
I'm gonna put them in one at a time. Of course, she's got a big old fancy photo of herself up here. I love putting them in one at a time because I love seeing them up here. Because you can just push Z to like put them all in at once. But I love putting them all in at one at a time. It just feels like really ominous here. I'm so scared. But I'm not that scared. I've beaten Grunty a few times. I'm excited. I'm excited more than anything.
I'm sad to say, down there you'll stop, cause I'm safe here at the top.
Debatable. All right, and here's the room from the game over cutscene. I love that you could just go here too. I guess they figure because it's like in the cutscene there, they'll just like stick it off to the side. I really love that aspect about this. You can't go into either of these doors here, but there you go. 2D's already saved, so she's not in there anymore. No Klungo to be seen. I don't know where he is. Well, I don't know where he even lives at this point, but let's go on to the finale area here. And you can see there's a bunch of note doors. There's also Dingpot. What's up, dude?
Phew! What a disgusting smell!
Visitors for Dingpot. I like visitors!
It's a wonder you get any sewer breath.
What does strange Betty thing mean?
She said that we're looking for Gruntilda. Do you know where she is?
I sure do, Mr. Bear. Grunty's awful, you know. She was
sicking me earlier on. Ew! If you get rid of her, I'll be free. Don't be sure, you silly pot. Soon I'll have you nice and hot. See these filthy clothes I've got? When I've won, you'll wash the lot!
Don't worry, Dingpot. We'll sort her out if you can find us a way up there.
No problem.
Just splash on in and I'll fire you up to the top.
Jump in there? No way, Dungbox.
Dungbox?
Come on, Kazooie. Get a chance to pet the witch's butt. Let's go.
Can't you get here any faster? Come on and fight me, I'm the master.
We'll see about all that. We'll see about all that. Well, anyway, if you get the full 900 notes, you'll have access to these wonderful refills. If you get all of the Cheeto pages, or all the Cheeto pages, all of the Cheeto locations, you'll have double of all of your items, and you will be more than ready for this final fight. More than ready. You'll notice there are four doors in here. Four doors and 7 years ago. Let's go see what that fourth door is. This is my favorite little secret. With the most notes that you need to unlock this little area, there is one final picture. So yeah, notice my jiggy count. There's literally only two jiggies in the game. Like, you can complete this game almost nearly 100% and you're left over with only two jiggies. It's crazy. And there you go. Not only do we have double eggs, double feathers, we also have double life. Haha! So those red bars will drain before our yellow ones, so.
Did I tell you she puked in me?
It was awful. Thanks for reminding me, Dungpot.
Or sorry, Dingbox. What is his name? Dingpot. Grunty called him Dungbox, and I got that stuck in my head.
I can't believe that furry bear got right up here. It's so unfair, but now the stupid bear must fight this battle. Test your skill and might.
And mighty I am. Banjo's gonna flex on you, dude. You don't even know what's up. Oh, God! You don't even know. This is the coolest boss fight in the entire history of Nintendo 64 games. Please, please prove me wrong. Please show me a better boss fight than the Grunty boss fight. Like, literally any fight from the N64 game era. Oh, shoot. What am I doing? I don't know why I thought she was going to stop before swiping at me, but here we are. Shut up, Grunty. Stop laughing. You're annoying. Says the guy who laughs constantly as his thing. There's very few refills in here too, so if you don't have the double eggs and double feathers, like this whole segment can be, you can run out of stuff pretty quick if you don't have like your refills and everything. So it is encouraged to 100% the game, just so you have those free easy refills for whenever you like lose to Grunty, if that comes down to it. All right, now she's gonna do an unavoidable. This homes in on you, so you have to use your gold feathers to avoid her. And then, oh, wait, phase two. I thought she was gonna go over here, but nope. I got backwards here. Okay, one, two, three, four. She's gonna shoot four and then take a break. And then I'm gonna get up here, fire some eggs in her general vicinity. And then she's gonna go counterclockwise, or clockwise, actually, around here. So we're just gonna jump on this corner and start firing at her before she even can fire at me. She's gonna keep getting faster, so we're gonna try to like get a little bit ahead of her. Ooh, crap. Okay, I didn't get ahead of her here, I don't think. Well, yeah, I did. Ooh, don't die! Okay, we did it. That was pretty fast, actually. Here we go. What you got for me next?
Ha! Quick, use this fly pad to get up there and teach her a lesson, Banjo! Oh boy!
Here, we'll just get this real quick. Top off my life, you know? Top off my double life. Really, I should have no trouble with this at all, honestly.
Ah, you got me again. Prepare to take this, sizzle brain.
You got me again. Prepare to take this, sizzle brain. I gotta, like, pronounce it correctly so that it rhymes. Because I say again, not again. Grunty, are you British? Grunty, your British is showing. Cease. Cease movement. Cease. Cease and desist. Yeah, there we go. You can kind of lead her shots too, or you can kind of lead her a little bit to try and hit her while she's moving like this, which is nice. Ooh, or you can just miss entirely. And it's very easy to run yourself directly into the ground if you're not careful. I have done that before. It ain't fun. Hey, stop moving. God, man, it takes so long. Just remember, you want to aim Kazooie's head at the middle of wherever you're aiming. So I am not doing a grand job at this at the moment. I'm also trying to hit her before she stops. And also, that is not recommended. Okay, now she's stopping. Oh, but she's so fast. Yeah, this last one, it's better to just lead her. I also don't want to get hit midair. That would be bad also. And I don't want to aim downwards. Remember, you can use R to turn quickly in midair. I was doing really good up until this moment here. Woo, buddy. Woo, buddy. Oh, she hit me. Shit.
Another hit you took once more. Please lose soon. I'm saddle sore.
Oh, from sitting on the broomstick? Her freaking, you know. She's not feeling too good down there right now. Riding that stick. That broomstick. I don't blame her. I think about that whenever I see Harry Potter stuff. I'm like, that must have hurt their freaking crotch. Oh my God, what is happening? Why am I doing this to myself? This is like the hardest part of the whole fight, actually, in my opinion. Oh, I was gonna lead your shot and she stopped right as I did it. There we go. Got it. Christ. That should be the last hit, right? Yeah. And now she's got an impenetrable shield. I need a shield to hide my dress. No, you don't. All right, now it's just Dodge Town. So one of the cool things is you can kind of lead her shots a little bit. You know, you can figure out where she's... Ah, the Jinjo statues, yes. So she's gonna try to throw her shots in front of wherever you're going. So if you just turn right as she's about to land her shots, you can kind of like direct her shots away from where you're trying to go. All right, Jinjo number one. Also, these Jinjos are big. Look at this big Jinjo. Big boys. These are like, this is like the Jinjo Council. Ah! I don't know what the lore is here, but I do believe that these are like the head Jinjos that were trapped by Grunty, and now you have to rescue them, and they help you defeat her. It's so cool. I love this part. Get away from me. Jinjo! They're so cute. I want all the Jinjos. Fangamer has a bunch of Jinjo plushes, and I want to buy them all. I have the blue one, and I have the Ginginator. Oops, spoiler alert, Ginginator. That's okay, we're about to see him here in a second anyway. Ah! It's a good thing I got those double lives. I'm kind of like just tanking hits at this point. Oof, you've winded me all around. Sorry, I missed what she said there, but that's okay. She rhymed. That's all I know. Ow. Ow, part two. How did that even hurt? What? I got hit by the explosion exclusively. All right, yeah, do your worst. Your worst is not very good. Here he is.
I am Mighty Ginginator. Activate me.
What's all this? How dare you cheat? But I don't care. I can't be beat.
Yeah, we'll see about all that. Okay, there's one. Oh, shit. There's two. And she's gonna do this number. And then I'm gonna do this. And then she's gonna do more of those. Ow! Didn't mean to get hit, that's fine. Let's get this last one in, and that's done. And time! Unleash the Jinjo God! Dear Ginginator, please kill Grunty.
Grunty's strength will see me through. When Jinjo's gone, I'll batter you. Poor old Grunty set to fall upon this spell I'll now call.
Miss, you got stormtrooper energy.
This should not be. So hurry, Klungo, rescue me. Yo, it's time to vacay, baby.
Little Jinjo, there's Tootie drinking out of a coconut. Banjo's got another drink. Bottle's got a melon. Speaking of melons, oh God. Hey, it's our boy Blubber. He's got his jet ski. He's got his new boat that he bought with his gold that we got for him. Speaking of melons though, I mean, come on. Those are some delicious melons for sure.
Duh, this is great. We have we finished, Tootie? Can I relax?
Sure, Banjo. You and Kazooie are heroes now.
Did you hear that, Shorty? I'm a hero.
Yes, I suppose you are. Huh? Well done, Kazooie. Oh, boy.
Thanks, Goggles. You're not so dumb after all.
That's enough, Kazooie. Let's all watch the cast list now.
And here we go. This is one of my favorite aspects of this game, actually. That it goes through and shows you all of the bonus characters. Like, the credits show you all the main characters in the game and a lot of, like, the big, like, the characters you all interact with that tell you their name and stuff. And this one is, like, all the side characters and enemies. So this is Topper. I love this. This is so great. I love their creative names, too. Ball. Balls to you.
Collywobble.
Collywobble. Listen, these freaking vegetables are terrifying. Let's be honest. They're actually terrifying. Hey, it's a Gruntling. Yeah. There's Ticker. And if you get 100% in this game, there's Big Butt. See, I told you. Big Butt. I love it. And if you complete the game 100%, there's a bonus cutscene after this. So just a little bit of a bonus that tells you some stuff that you missed. Aw, our boy Leaky. He helped us get all he helped us get into the Treasure Trove Cove Sandcastle. I didn't show it, but he helped us get in every single time I went back there to put in one of those stop and swap codes. There's Little Lockup. The fact that that little chest even has a name is crazy.
Yub Yub. Yub Yub is Dub Dub.
Snippet! Little snippets.
Treasure Trove Cove is absolutely my favorite. Every time I look at it, I'm just like, I want to live there. I want to set up shop in Treasure Trove Cove. Just like a little island. It reminds me actually so much of that, like, the Outset Island mod that I played reminded me a lot of Treasure Trove Cove in a lot of ways. It's just like, I just want to live here, man. I love Outset Island.
Grill Chompa!
I was having a hard time remembering the name, and I called them Great Chompas. Like, great as in grating.
Muty Snippets!
Here we are in Clanker's Cavern. I love this too because not only does it serve as like, here's the names of all the enemies that you fought throughout the game and the other character, like the side characters that you found, but also it's a sort of like a reminder of all the levels that you visited. Here we are in the swamp, Bubble Glue Swamp, which was my first death. Aw, baby's first death. Ugh, no, don't say that. That's not good. That's not good, no. I died in the video game. Aw, here we are in Freeze Easy. There's the kids, those poor kids with their horrible father that has abandoned them several times. No wonder these kids turn out so bad in Tooie. If you've played Tooie, you understand what I'm talking about. These kids do not grow up to be good. Hey, I love the Twinklies. This is going to be hyping up all of the... Yeah, screw these guys, though. Hyping up all of the side characters. It's like my favorite aspect of this whole game. And Rare, like, the whole, like, development team at Rareware in the 90s and early 2000s was just the most creative group of people ever. And they came up with some really inventive characters that you, like, actually remember and care about throughout the game, even if you only interact with them once or they're, like, an enemy that you've never seen before. It's wild. Never seen before. An enemy that you, like, kill. You know, it's still interesting. Like, Grabba is here. We got Slappa. I'm assuming he's coming up now. Scabby, what is that? That's a Scarab? Scabby the Scarab. There's Slappa. There's the boy. I hate you. You creepy mother trucker.
Mum mum. Mum mum is dub dub.
Mum mum. Hey, Hisstop. I miss that boy. I like Hisstop. That's also where Ruby and Toots are.
Mozhand.
Mozhand. It's like Mozart, but also a hand. We are in. Yeah, the portrait chompas. Mad Monster Mansion was one of my favorite levels when I was a kid. Teehee!
Teehee!
Limbo! Oh my god, you guys remember Limbo? Like the game? I did a Let's Play of that years ago, and it was one of my favorite series, actually. Should go look it up. It's an old one. Aw, it's Nibbly.
I'm Batman. Boombox.
Poor guy.
Boss Boombox.
I also just love this music, too. The credits music is so nostalgic. Grimlet, you scary mother trucker, appearing in my nightmares here. Floatsome! Seaman grublin! Seaman!
Chump!
I never got hurt by Chump at all. I don't even think we saw Chump. Not once in this whole series. I avoided Chump like the plague. There he is, Big Clucker. That's me, you guys. You can call me Big Clucker. Actually, I did pretty good this episode, so... you know, I think I'm free of Big Cluckerness at this point. I'm free of being a Big Clucker. Wait, I missed a Jiggy! Guys, I missed a Jiggy! It was right there all along! Aw, Cheeto. I miss you already, Cheeto. Favorite character. That melon girl is just walking around this island in circles at this point.
Whoa.
Yo, what's up, Mumbo?
Hey, Mumbo got secret pictures.
I don't want to see your secret pictures, Mumbo. I don't want to see your nudes. Put those away.
Got pictures of things you missed. Secrets used in next game.
About that.
Ooh, did you hear that, Kazooie? We're going to be in another game.
Great. So let's see the pictures then, skirt boy.
Look, Mumbo can wear a skirt if he wants to. Did you get all 100 jigsaw pieces?
Yes, in fact I did.
We sure did, Mr. Mumbo.
I remember one time I forgot one of the witch jiggies and I got here and it was like 99 jiggies. And when he says that, he's like, yeah, you gotta go back and get 100 jiggies before I show you these pictures. I'm like, wait, what? I thought I got 100. But no, I missed one time. It was sad.
Banjo-Tooie sounds great. Is it any good?
Breaking the fourth wall, like, immensely here.
Mumbo's jaw dropped in awe.
It is pretty good. I do like Banjo-Tooie.
Hey, why isn't it called Banjo-Kazooie-Tooie? I'd better be in it, too. Short stuff.
Banjo-Tooie make Banjo-Kazooie look like joke. Mumbo show you pictures of stuff can use in new game. Here, take look.
Yeah, about that, Mumbo. I did get all these things. So, just know, he's gonna show us some stop and swap secrets. But, I already showed you. How'd you make that rock rise up?
Her.
Mumbo not telling.
Mumbo knows the secret codes. And he's willing to put in the time and effort to slam them into the Treasure Trove Cove sandcastle.
What's up there, dumb skull?
Dumb skull. I'm gonna start using that one. That's like way better than numbskull.
Dumb skull.
Looks rather high.
Don't worry, Banjo. It looks like I have to get us up there.
Fun fact, in the Xbox Live Arcade version of this game, this video of the picture going up, the player actually falls off and they don't ever see the top where the egg is. I don't know why that is. Like, they must have re-recorded it for the Xbox Live Arcade version in, like, a higher quality. And then the person who recorded it just fell off. And they didn't fix it.
Next secret found in snow.
That's Waz's cave.
This is where the ice key was. God, just imagine not knowing those codes as a kid. And having this blow your entire mind. And then you're like, wait, it's used in the next game? And then you get to the next game, and it just doesn't. It just doesn't. Imagine, like, the frustration of not knowing for so many years about Stop and Swap. It was also really fascinating, and one of my absolute favorite, like, legends in video games. The Legend of the Ice Key.
Did she just say what I think she said? Did you see what she said? I know where I'd stick that. What?
Another secret in desert.
There's the blue egg. He only shows you these three things, by the way. He doesn't show you any of the other eggs. But these are probably the most special ones anyway, the ones that have, like, their own rooms and things.
No, bird rude to Mumbo, not tell.
I wonder what's in there.
Ha! Huh. It's only another stupid egg. Kazooie's seen many eggs. Kazooie has pooped many an egg throughout this game. She's sick of it.
Wow, how do we get those?
Mumbo, not tell.
You find out in Banjo-Tooie. Banjo find out in Banjo-Tooie. We'll see. We shall see. Well, that is everyone. Thank you so much for watching Banjo-Kazooie. Once again, I've been Josh Jepson. Thank you for subscribing, leaving comments that I love reading every day, liking these videos to help the algorithm push these videos out to new people, and I will see you guys in the next series, whatever the next thing is. Oh, there's a bonus episode of this as well. Some other secrets that I have yet to show. The bottles bonuses, for those that know.
All the G's you did snatch, but I'll be back for my rematch!
The end! Woo! Yeah! Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you in the next one.